Okay, go ahead, doctor.
Okay, hi, I'm Ola. I'm a registered nurse. I'm work in a public health and I'm a lecturer with Emek Israel College in Israel. Research is about predictors of stressor, anxiety, and depression among pregnant women during the first wave in the COVID-19 pandemic in Israel. During and after natural disaster, pandemic, pregnant women are at increased risk of psychological and mental disorder, including higher level of anxiety and depression. Studies report an alarmingly elevated level of psychological distress, especially anxiety and depression among pregnant individuals. In general, pregnant women are vulnerable to infection disease like influenza A, MRSA, SARS, and Ebola. Serious complications of pregnancy were reported with this infection, including increased maternal with this including increased maternal mortality and morbidity, intrauterine fetal death, spontaneous abortion, and preterm delivery. Compared to other these, a COVID-19 outcome for the mother appears more promising, as no maternal mortality was reported, and most infected women developed mild respiratory symptoms. That's in the first wave. Fetal complication of COVID-19 infection include the miscarriage, intrauterine growth restriction, and preterm birth, but no confirmed cases of vertical transmission were reported. Naturally, no data is yet COVID-19 available on prenatal outcome when the infection was acquired early in the pregnancy. A significant factor in adequacy of medical follow-up during pregnancy is the fear of women from any contact with hospitals or medical staff due to the understandable concern regarding acquiring the infection, which has so many unknowns regarding its consequences. In China, this was formally evaluated and reported. The purpose of my study was to evaluate by a web-based questionnaire the emotional status of a predictor of stress, anxiety, and depression among pregnant women who gave birth during the pandemic in Israel, compared to those who had their recent baby during the year before. A cross-sectional study in which pregnant women and the women up to a year after childbirth in a postpartum period, resident of northern Israel, Jewish and Arab, we ask through a social network to fill in an online questionnaire during the COVID-19 pandemic in the first wave. The questionnaire researched 422 women who were asked to participate. Overall, 356 women, 251 pregnant, and 101 postpartum responded. The questionnaire included an assessment of general stress, anxiety, and depression, stress specific to COVID-19, and other obstetric and demographic variable of the study population. The reliability of each part of the questionnaire was tested separately using Cronbach alpha test. The data was completed during the general quarantine period in April to May. This study was conducted in accordance with the Helsinki Declaration and approved by Ethic Committee of the Israeli Valley College. On the first page of the questionnaire, electronic informed consent was obtained for each participant before beginning the questionnaire. We use stress assessment, PSS 9 perceived stress scale, a questionnaire that examines the extent to which an individual assessed life is stress and refers to perception and emotional related to the overall stress level recently. Anxiety question, a general anxiety disorder, 7-item item questionnaire was used to assess objective anxiety symptom of over the past month. Depression question, we use the PHQ-Q2 questionnaire was of which at least one positive item is required to diagnose the major depression disorder for any depressive disorder according to DSM-4. COVID-19 related stress perception, the questionnaire was composed by us by me and other researchers for this study. Six statements reflecting in the degree of the concern, such as I fear someone in my family will acquire COVID-19, or I am afraid of acquiring COVID-19 in a hospital during labor. Result, demographic and health data by study group of the 352 women included in this study and 251 were pregnant women and 101 postpartum. The demographic of pregnant women did not differ from that of their postpartum counterpart. Expect that a significantly higher percentage of pregnant women worked remotely during the pandemic compared to their postpartum women. Comparison of stress, anxiety, depression, and stress from corona between pregnant women and the woman up of a year after childbirth. Among 251 pregnant women, 41 reported high stress and 56 high anxiety. 103 reported high level of depression. No different in stress, anxiety, depression, and stress from COVID-19 was found between pregnant and postpartum women. Stress from COVID-19 among pregnant women, the most prevalent stressor attributed to COVID-19 among the pregnant women were fear that someone of their family will acquire the virus, concern for the health of the baby, fear that someone close will die from COVID-19, worry of being infected within the hospital. Predictive stressor, we can see here that the predictive of stressor among pregnant women, I focus in the result of about the pregnant woman, multivariate stepwise logistic regression analysis revealed that only fear of being alone in the hospital or at home was predictor of stress. A predictor of anxiety among a pregnant woman, we can see that multivariation stepwise logistic regression analysis revealed that religion and income level below the mean were predictor of anxiety. There were no two-way interaction between religions and income level or academic education and income level. The fears of acquiring COVID-19 had being alone in the hospital at home after delivery, each increased the odds of having high level of anxiety fourfold as compared to women without these fears. Financial worries increased the odds of the having a high level of anxiety threefold as compared to women without these worries. a predictor about depression among pregnant women, we can see, as shown in the table, multivariate stepwise logistic regression analysis shows that religion was the only significant predictor of depression after correcting for religion's fear of acquiring COVID-19, financial worries, and fear of beginning alone is the hospital where the only predictor of depression with the odd ratio 2.3, 2.8, and 2.6 respectively. Now a discussion. We can see that we found that most pregnant women reported high stress, anxiety, and depression during the COVID-19 pandemic due to variety of factors. That leading factor were fear that someone in their family will acquire the virus, concern for the health of the baby, fear of someone close will die from COVID-19, age and income level below the mean were also predictor of stressor. During a large scale disaster or deep change of life, emotional response are overwhelming. In some aspects, depression, anxiety, and stress may overlap. However, there are separate entities which demand adjusted intervention if corrective measures are considered. In the light of this view, it is the prime importance to define the main factor that act in inducing any of these three emotional states. Overall, the group of women who respond to our questionnaire had higher level of education than in Israeli average. This overwhelming presence of people in this higher ties of education should be considered when viewing the result. Interestingly, lower education was a predictor only for higher anxiety, but not for stress or depression. This suggests that depression and stress affect equally academically educated and less academic women. This result may be partially explained by the enforced distancing from extended family member and friends, as well as the inevitable strategy created by the mask covered face with the gloved hand that one encounter upon reaching for medical support. This becomes even more pronounced when one factor is in the understandable stressful and worried manners of medical teams members being themselves under the risk of acquiring the infection. In the northern part of the country, during the first wave of the pandemic, very few cases were recorded, and the chances of acquiring the virus for an average northern district Israeli citizens were exceptionally low. Yet financial condition or concern about the future of the financial condition were important predictor of all three emotional states, emphasis the central importance of economy aspect during the current pandemic, which left the country with about 20 percentage employment rate. It is worth nothing noting, in this regard that the north of Israel is considered as a peripher, which historically had been hit economically worse than the central region of the country during the crisis the crisis. Additionally, at this initial stage of the outbreak, both information about COVID-19 and pregnancy and focused information and education by the authorities were fragmentary. This is run put pregnant women under tremendous level of uncertainty, which could serve to increase any aspect of negative emotional response of all these anxiety. But its nature is the one which most affected by uncertainty. Indeed, we found that the financial worries, fear of acquiring the virus, and fear of being trapped alone in the hospital, all reflected uncertainty, were the most prominent predictor of anxiety. The other element being and the predictor of all three conditions is fear of remaining alone. This may reflect both adequate response to a reality which left relative separated due to mere chance, and a reflection of Middle East culture tendency to view oneself as just a unit of the large entity of the whole family. This may hold true especially for women. In future crises, this like the current one, all attention should be given first to a coherent flow of information from authorities to the public and then to the concessions. Effort to overcome the mask barriers, which alienates patients and serve to put them under press. Research implication looking to the future, one must draw a practical guideline for future major crisis situation, which according to some authorities are imminent. The point to be considered are education for medical and allied professional regarding the central issue concerning pregnant women during crisis. Among these should be alleviation of uncertainty by the provision of maximum information, addressing individual concern regarding the economic effect of the situation, advocating regarding the needs of family adaptation to address the situation. Two, drawing the required respond by the network of social work or community nurse following a declaration of crisis preparing scripts to address those parts of a population who had an inevitable event, such as labor or major planned operation, to provide clear guidelines for behavior under the new crisis situation. Thank you for hearing me. This is my table graphic.